Yeah, welcome to this video. New 5-minute blitz game against Roadrunners from Australia. Yeah, the King's Indian. Let's see, I recently won a nice game with the exchange, but yeah, we don't get it this time. Okay. I know it's Bishop G2, right? Yeah, this is a very weird line. I know this G4 anticipates black playing E5, and instead he can play C5, and we get this position now, which is very similar to a Meroxy bind. The difference is, or the weird thing is, that I have a pawn on G4, but other than that, it's just normal. The weird thing is, in addition, that black has got some really badly placed pieces, queen on e8 in particular. I'm sorry. Yeah, how to continue? Let's play queen d2 first. Connect rooks. Not so sure how to set up the pieces here. Sometimes there's even f4 and e5 as a possible plan. Yeah, he tries to prepare b5. Maybe I can play knight d5 on this. Okay, knight d5 now, maybe. Yeah, shouldn't be too bad. Pressurizing f6. Not sure, but maybe I'm really threatening to take it on f6 and damage his pawn structure. If he takes and I recapture with the e-pawn, I should have an excellent position with the e7 pawn being a target. Yeah, I'm not sure what he should do now. Maybe b5 after all. It's not easy to play. Or knight e6. Maybe he can allow that. I'm not sure. The problem is, whenever I give up this bishop on g5, my dark squares are weakened. This position would be without any doubt better for white with the pawn on g3, but it's on g4. It's not much that I can do against that. And this weakens the king side. Yeah, he's not moving. Need to check quickly. Oh, he's got a good ping time even. So it's not a disconnection. Yeah, not sure what he's doing. He's not moving at all. Yeah, there must be some problem. No one is going to think 1.5 minutes on this move. Okay, now he's moving. Yeah, the question is, here, should I take to take or not to take? Hmm. Not sure. Maybe it is better to keep pieces on and increase with rook d1 and so on. Knight takes f6. Bishop takes. I'm not sure that I can get pressure on d6 so quickly, and I don't really want to exchange the dark squared bishop. Knight to d5. I should threaten that maybe. That right now it's not a threat, but here it is. Or bishop f6 and knight d5. This may be a threat now. Bishop f6, bishop f6, knight d5, queen d2, knight f6, check, king g7, and then maybe just of recapture on d2, and king f6 looks like he's got some problems. Oh, wait. Knight d5 now. That's even knight e7. Okay, let's do this.
Check.
Interesting. Should I? Knight h5 is ridiculous, probably. And now f4 or not? Yeah, probably f4 and e5. If he goes, or he doesn't. I thought he would play e5 himself, but didn't do that. Okay, man, let's use the space here. Yeah, but I have this b4 and c5 should be strong. This was always important that I have this idea. This bishop b7 as well. B7 and taking. Yeah, I can actually do that. Wait. Oh yeah, I can do that. Maybe he's going to d5. That's a bit tricky now. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't have taken. this is unnecessarily complicated now. I shouldn't have done that. Just a simple technical play would have won rather easily, and now this isn't so clear even. Oh, this is covered. Oh no.
Time warning.
Don't believe that. It's impossible. Yeah, what a nonsense game. I'm completely dominating this and then stupidly giving it away.
Check. forfeits on time.
Yeah, why on earth did I grab the a6 pawn? I mean, this is just over this position. Just with normal moves. Rook e3 or something, dominating the knight. After that, he doesn't even have a move. I mean, well, maybe you can play what I did, but it's not a practical choice in a blitz game. Let's check this, but probably I really shouldn't do that. Yeah, this is the only move, but it's sufficient to continue this. Yeah, just something like this. He has no move. Absolutely no. I can try this. I just play a3 and this is over. I mean, I can even play bishop f1 later and pick this up conveniently. The knight has no move. It is dead on a4. No. Yeah, just bad play by me. Bishop b7 is just bad. All right, thanks for watching.